In Pixar's Monsters, Inc., the character Sully became popular in animation circles, but not for the reasons that most people think about. Sully stands 8 feet tall and is covered in 2.3 million individual hairs, each of which had to be animated and rendered. The problem is, this is a feat never attempted at this scale before. The studio's existing tools couldn't handle such complexity, so Pixar's engineers spent years developing a new fur simulation system. The result was a custom software called Fist, which allowed animators to achieve unprecedented realism in Sully's fluffy and blue-purple fur. And even with this breakthrough, rendering Sully's fur was enormously time-consuming. Single frames took on the render of 11 to 12 hours just to process his fur details. You see, this extreme effort was necessary to make Sully's fur move convincingly in wind, react to touch, and subtly shadow itself like real hair. Behind the scenes, the technical challenge of Sully's fur required a blend of artistic skills and heavy-duty computation. Pixar approached the problem by treating each hair as a physical particle within a dynamic system. In practice, 28,000 guide hairs were hand-placed and groomed on Sully's body to define the overall look and behavior of the fur. The Fist simulator treated those guide strands as a basis to animate all 2.3 million hairs, applying physics so that hairs would stay together, collide, and avoid interpenetrating each other. The software understood forces like gravity and wind, meaning Sully's fur could flutter when he walked or bristle when he sneezed, without animators having to tweak each strand by hand. For example, if Sully carried an object, like a child, or walked through a draft, the software would automatically make his fur part a ripple in response. This autonomy was crucial, because it freed Pixar's artists to focus on performance instead of laboriously keyframing hair motion. But making fur behave realistically was only half the battle. Pixar also had to render it believably. Standard rendering techniques in the late 90s actually struggled with hair, which can look very wrong if lit improperly. Sully's fur demanded new shading algorithms to handle complexities like self-shadowing, translucency, and motion blur of millions of tiny fibers. The Pixar's renderman team literally rewrote parts of the renderer for this task. They implemented deep shadow maps, which is an advanced shadowing method, so that each hair could gas shaft colored shadows onto other hairs, avoiding the flat look which plagued earlier hair renders. You see, all this technology pushed Pixar's infrastructure to the limit. The studio's render farm swelled to 3,500 processors to churn through the fur and cloth simulations, and the overall computing demand for Monsters, Inc. was more than their three previous films combined. Some complex shots took upward to 80 hours per frame to render due to the massive detail. It is no wonder that Pixar uses Sully's fur as a benchmark. The film consumed 2.5 million render marks, their internal metric for rendering work. And this is a gigantic leap over anything attempted before. And despite the daunting computing cost, the payoff was clear. Sully appeared on screen with a rich, tentacle coat that audiences accepted as part of him, not just a CG trick. If the hair looks so good that you don't think about it, this is because it feels like a natural part of the character, in which case we have succeeded, said Pixar's Dan McCoy. And generally, I think Sully's fur set a new bar for animated characters. Overall, it was a breakthrough that proved CG characters could be fuzzy and soft, and not like the films before them, such as Toy Story 1, which looked great but not realistic enough. And there you have it, guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to this channel to receive more videos like this. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.